a gentleman by the name of Ixiochus supposedly tied the first fly. That's some 2,000 years ago. And maybe a trout fly, who knows.
And thus began mankind's pursuit of fish and ways to catch them. Over time, people studied what and how fish ate. Soon the art of tying flies developed. Ellis Hatch started tying his own flies when he discovered fly fishing, which didn't happen right off.
Well, everybody starts out with a spinning rod because that seems to be the easiest. And I did a little spin fishing for bass, but I'd go up north to Pittsburgh to go fishing and I'd see people fly fishing and, you know, in my teens. And I said, hey, okay, I got to try this. So I got started in it and gradually I put the spinning rod away. Attach this right in front of the point. In the beginning, I had a very generous brother-in-law, and he was a pretty good fly tier. And he used to tie the flies for me back when we were fishing Flat Mountain Pond. And he got a little tired of tying flies for me, especially when I was leaving them in the trees behind me. So he said, you know, I've got to teach you how to tie these things. He says, I don't have the time to keep supplying you with these things. You're going to keep losing them.
And that's when Ellis started tying his own flies. He's been tying them for close to 45 years now.
In a good day's fly tying, I might get 100 flies. If I can get 150 woolly buggers in a day, I feel I had a real good day. And my fly tying days begin at 4 in the morning in the wintertime and go till 7 at night. And the key in fly tying is having good materials. It's very important. You know, you've got 6 or 7 basic tools that you need and a good vise, something to hold the hook. And then you need good materials. And if you've got good materials, it makes the job easier.
For some fly fishermen, tying flies is practical, a means to an end. However, there are some who take a different approach.
For me, it's my art. It's actually like painting a picture. I mean, I sit down at the vise, I put a bear hook in, when I put that fly together, I'm thinking about things like balance and symmetry and proportion and colors. And there's always, even though perfection is an unattainable goal, there is always an element for me when I do these to always push that limit.
Mark Favorite is a classic Atlantic salmon fly tier. He's teaching Bob Wyatt to tie these intricate flies through a grant from the New Hampshire State Council for the Arts. Bob met Mark at a fly tying exhibition. He'd always wanted to learn more about tying the classic Atlantic salmon fly.
I got talking to Mark and he told me about his apprenticeships that he does with the New Hampshire State Council in the Arts, and it evolved from there.
The program itself is unique in that it allows someone who has an art form to teach another individual that art form. For me, it's special because I see the students when they come, and I know where they are when they begin. And so over the course of that time, not only do we develop and build a friendship, but I also see them bloom with regards to acquiring their skills and the end product.
The classic Atlantic salmon fly is considered by some to be the pinnacle of fly tying.
It's very time consuming. The flies are, in order to create them, involve a number of steps. It's not a fly tying endeavor, at least what I do, to get the fly tied and go out and fish with it. It's really creating something that is going to be something beautiful to behold.
We try to get our mindset back in tradition, back into the 1800s, so we want to put the silk in the feathers.
Mark and Bob are both avid anglers. The tying of classic Atlantic flies is just a further extension of the passion they have for the sport.
I think it's important because it speaks to a time that has long since gone by. This is just an incredible, colorful characters, many stories that are told about Atlantic salmon fly. fishing in the British Isles and most recently in Northern America, that makes it an interesting folklore-ish, if you will, ties generations together. There's some linkage there.
Ellis also enjoys tying flies as an extension of the sport he cares for. But in the end, it all comes back to fishing.
Oh, an escape, get away from the telephone, get out in an environment like this where it's you and the water, and, you know, trying to fool the fish. Sometimes you do. They call it fishing, not catching. So there are days you go out there and it may be an effort. Other days it's easy.